What is the single most common mental health issue in the world? Hundreds of millions of people suffer from it, and yet if you do, you can feel totally alone. It's anxiety. And if you're stuck in a loop of negative thoughts, you can break the pattern. Here's the story of one woman who found a way to literally change her mind. I'm Dr. Ozuah, and this is The Balance.
I'm cleverly hiding this. I think that this chair, in many ways, is a metaphor for my life because it's beautiful. It's aging fantastically, much like myself, but it's also falling apart. Sometimes the stuffing comes out.
If we're just looking at adults with some type of anxiety disorder, the estimates are around 40 million people in the United States.
I'm Sara Benincasa. I'm an author, a comedian, and a person with agoraphobia.
Catastrophic thinking is a part of agoraphobia. It is a term that's used for people who tend to think the worst, no matter what type of anxiety disorder they have. Even though we can't see it, it can be devastating.
Everybody with any anxiety disorder has different triggers. For me, as someone with agoraphobia, it has to do with being afraid of being out in the open air, out among people, out in a crowd. If you're the person on the street in New York City who is being the wildest one, something is wrong because you've got a lot of competition. There's no end to the amount of bizarre scenarios I can make up walking down the street to try and convince myself to stay inside. A cab could hit me, a car could hit me, a motorcycle running into me, a dog could attack me, a branch falling and hitting me, an asteroid could drop from the sky and blow me to smithereens. Like, it doesn't exist in a logical space. And you don't have control. And in New York City, you don't have control over other people's behavior or of an AC unit falling on your head. Physically, my heart rate increases. I start to sweat. Sometimes I get tingling in my hands or my feet. Suddenly, you're reacting as if you're in a horror movie, but you're like in the park, having a lovely day.
The curse of anxiety disorders is not only in the fact that you're suffering, the curse is in the invisibility to other people.
There are beautiful things about being abnormal. But when we have to describe these experiences that happen outside the realm of what is, say, healthy or manageable, it can become difficult. It sounds bizarre to other people because it is bizarre.
The good news is that there are highly effective treatments. There's a particular type of talk therapy called cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT for short. We learn to challenge thoughts that could be getting in the way and change behavioral patterns that could be getting in the way of you leading the life that you want.
So for me, my routine is daily exercise, daily medication. I talk to my talk therapist once a week.
These catastrophic thoughts that emerge when one feels anxious, you test out how accurate they are. You practice, you have homework exercises that you are given by your therapist between sessions.
Meditation is definitely part of my medicine. It really helps a lot to quiet the mind, to slow down the nervous system in general. It's quite helpful. Hey everybody, it's Sara Benincasa. Welcome to... I've been really fortunate. I've gotten to make creative lemonade out of mental illness lemons, and my life is pretty good. I have been able to get to a place where I can share my story with other people. I can use it creatively in some of the books that I've written and some of the scripts that I've written. It's helped me connect more with other human beings. I'm pretty lucky.
You can learn a lot when you walk a mile in someone else's shoes, or even just a New York City block. I'm Dr. Ozuah, and this has been The Balance. Until next time, be well.